says yes, David Walliams. Stand up, Holly Walsh. Your team captain, Jason Manford. And facing them tonight, King of the Road, Jeremy Clarkson. Tonight, he's hired from The Apprentice, James McQuillan. And their team captain, Sean Locke. Now, welcome your host, Jimmy Carr.
Hello, and welcome to 8 out of 10 Cats, a show about opinion polls, surveys, and statistics. Did you know, for example, 32% of women believe it's possible to communicate with the dead? So don't bother trying to kill yourself, she'll still be rabbiting on. In the UK, trousers cause twice as many accidents as chainsaws, which is true. I've had a lot of accidents in my trousers. A female mackerel lays 500,000 eggs at any one time. Slag. And 9% of cat owners claim their cat had a say in their choice of partner, and that choice of partner was not to have one. Let's get started. What are you talking about? That's the name of our first round. We've teamed up with a leading polling organisation and they've asked the British nation what stories they've been discussing this week. It's our panellists' job to guess the British public's top five most talked about things this week. Sean, what do you think the nation have been talking about?
The Apprentice.
The Apprentice?
The Apprentice. It was the final of The Apprentice and Sir Alan Sugar may decided finally to give someone a job.
I know he's
in
not...
his empire. Which I don't think is an empire. I think it's like a Greek island. I think he does everything. I think you go into his offices, he's dressed in a wig, and he goes, oh, Mr. Sugar will see you now. And he goes on with runs into the boardroom, sits there, is going, come in, sit down, tea or coffee? They go, tea. And he goes, hold on a sec. And he goes, no, no, no. Because I've never come across any kind of Amstrad or Sugar Enterprises in any part of
Have you not got
life.
A Faxophone 3000?
No.
The Faxophone 3000 they use, it's brilliant. It's like a MIDI hi-fi system with a fax.
It's like someone sellotapes a sort of flask to a banjo or something like that.
Just baffle me how he is so rich when... What is Amstrad? I mean, I had an Amstrad CPC 464 when I was 12.
Is that the one with the green writing?
Green screen, yes. And it loaded games off tapes. That was the system. And he's now a millionaire. He must own actual sugar.
James, do you think the right person won?
Yes, I think Yasmina was right to win, yeah.
The prize on this, Yasmina's prize, she won a job... at a digital signage firm.
Yeah, now,
I don't know much about digital signage, but is it that?
He is selling digital telly things with stuff on.
Wow.
You'd be good in that job because you know all the lingo.
That's right,
you?
Yeah.
Why didn't he pick Kate?
Did Kate lose because she's got a Birmingham accent? Because that's why I would have said no. I work with Richard Hammond. When he's had a drink, he becomes fully Birmingham and it's just intolerable noise. Does Sir Alan make you call him Sir Alan?
No one actually tells you that you do it. It's like, it might not be his real name.
Just why didn't you call him?
Is his real name?
His name's not Shirley. It's Alan.
I just find it all too fascinating, The Apprentice, because as far as I work out, all you actually do in there is spend 10% of your time doing something and then 90% working out who to blame when it goes wrong.
That's it. You have to kind of...
And Alan Sugar, you notice this, Alan Sugar, how cross he gets, because one team's made £8 and the other team's lost by 25 pence. But is it like that? And then what's that, Margaret?
She's let him speak!
It's like talking to an eight-year-old, isn't it?
Let him speak!
Why does he get so cross about 25p?
Yeah.
Get so cross.
God almighty!
Answer!
He hasn't made 800 odd million through, you know, look after the pennies and the 800 millions look after themselves.
It's that kind of homespun wisdom that lost you the whole thing.
Yeah. Do you know one thing I've picked up actually from watching it on the telly? I've just realised how bad my posture is. It's like I'm a prawn, like a jumbo prawn.
That's the main thing you've learnt from that experience.
Massive. I mean, how big are you, James? How
big are you? That's the question we're after.
There's a lot of big boys on that team. I want to know who's the biggest. Let's get you and Clarkson back to back. Come on, let's get you back to back.
Well, let's see it.
We're not going to get that response.
James,
James.
Come on, then.
James, he back just, to back.
He just said...
Just don't argue with me.
They are back to back, back to back.
James is bigger! James is bigger!
Yes!
Let's have a look and see whether The Apprentice is one of the most talked about things this week. Of course. Yes, it was the final of The Apprentice. I don't pretend to know much about business, but after watching Yasmina and Kate carefully analysing their business decisions and leadership qualities, I simply can't understand why Sir Alan didn't hire the pretty one. Sir Alan's been asked to sign on as the government's enterprise czar. James has been asked to sign on. OK, Jason, Holly and David, what else have the nation been talking about?
Well, it's got to be the...
European elections,
isn't it? Yeah.
Got to be the European elections, isn't it, Jimmy?
No, it's just the BNP going over there taking all their jobs. It's, yeah. It's pretty simple.
Someone threw an egg at him, didn't
it? Was it a British hen that laid the egg, do we know?
It was a brown egg that was thrown and that's what hurt. Oh.
Understand why the BNP even want to be, you know, in the European Parliament, because they're always going to be sat next to foreigners, aren't they, all the time? Unless that might cure them. They go over there and go, actually, it's quite nice, and the people are really friendly. Oh, what's that? Oh, croissant. I'm no longer a racist.
There's no difference to UKIP. All UKIP have got is, we don't like Europe.
Yeah.
So people who vote for them vote for UKIP and say, oh, we don't like Europe. But it's kind of pointless, UKIP going there, because they don't like Europe. It's a bit like going to someone's birthday party who you hate, refusing to sing happy birthday, eating all the cake and then going, this is a shit party.
And did you see the size of the voting paper for it?
Yeah, it's long. Yeah,
it was like a piece of bog roll. It was stretched all the way across the floor.
I just crossed all of them out and just put Hamas. They'll sort this borough out.
OK, let's have a look and see whether the European elections is one of the most talked about things this week. Yes, of course.